Track iteration progress with Rally. As a Scrum Master, product owner, or other organizer, it's important to monitor your team's progress each day. You can get a summary and detailed look into a team's progress from the iteration status page in the Track menu. Ensure that your workspace and project pickers are scoped to the correct team, and the current iteration will automatically be selected in the iteration picker. You can always change the iteration to look forward or review a past iteration. You can view the details of your iteration as cards on a board or from a list view. Both views provide filters to display only items that meet specific criteria. Expand the Stats banner to view important data points about the iteration's progress. Compare the percentage of accepted story points against the number of days remaining in the iteration to predict if the team will meet their commitments. Scrum Masters can mention the count of associated defects at each daily stand-up meeting, which should be driven down to zero by the end of the iteration. Three charts are available to visualize the team's progress. The pie chart provides a breakdown of your iteration work into color-coded states. In this example, the pie slices are stories and defects, and the pie crust represents tasks. The burndown chart shows amounts of work accepted and amounts of work remaining. The ideal line on this chart represents the pace you'd like to see your teams follow as the to-dos from the task hours go down and the accepted story points go up. The cumulative flowchart shows how work item states have progressed over time. This chart can help you identify bottlenecks in your process. Here you can see that work continued to be added and defined in the first two-thirds of the iteration. With so much work in progress, it might have been better for the team to swarm to get it completed rather than to add new work. You'll see from the very narrow completed band that the work was accepted almost as soon as it was completed. But then, as time progressed, it was not released right away. Although there are sometimes good reasons for this, it's best to release accepted work as soon as possible to avoid stale code that must continue to be merged with new changes as it awaits release. This code can become problematic if it's held for too long. Changes to work items can be done in bulk or inline in the list view. The board view is best for visualizing the state of your work items as they move across the schedule state columns. You can view tasks and associated work items by clicking the status icons on a card. Updates that contributors make to tasks will roll up to the associated user stories and defects. The blocked indicator displays as red when a team member has marked a work item as blocked. Team members can use the ready indicator to show that a work item is ready for the next schedule state. Product owners can accept completed work by moving the card to the accepted column or by updating the schedule state field in the list view. To learn more about Rally and Agile practices, check out our blog and community. Like this video and subscribe to our channel so that you never miss new content as it's added.